Audible now?
Yes, sir.
Okay. In the last lecture, we have started with module number 5. In that, there is a concept of normalization and there are different types of normalizations. We have covered first three normal forms and we understood why normalization question is required in the databases. There is always an importance of normalization when we talk about databases, because we don't want redundant data into the database. The major objective of normalization is to avoid the redundant data. Once the redundant data is removed from the database, your database size gets compressed and it has only the content which is related to the problem or related to the database that we want. So exact information will be available into a normalized database. We have seen this example of unnormalized table and what are the problems that occurred into unnormalized table. There are three different anomalies you should know that happens in this unnormalized table. There is insertion anomaly, updation and deletion anomaly. Anomaly means problems. This problem will going to occur when there are redundant data into your database. Then there are different steps that we follow in the process of normalization. A normal table is promoted to the next normal form, that is called as first normal form. There we actually remove the multi-valued attribute, or you can say a composite attribute, an attribute which takes more than one value for the same record. Such attribute has to be removed and it must be removed by keeping it into separate table. In second normal form, we actually look for, are there any partial dependencies exist between the database tables? If they are there, then we have to remove those partial dependencies by keeping them into separate tables. In third normal form, we found the transitive dependency. We look for transitive dependency. If there are any transitive dependency exist in your database tables, then they have to be removed again by splitting the table into subtables. In between third normal and fourth normal form, we have Boyce Codd normal form. Here, any remaining anomalies that result from the functional dependencies have been removed. Till this normal form, we deal only with the functional dependencies. But then there is another normal form that is called as fourth normal form, which deals with the multi-valued dependency. So we are going to study today the fourth normal form and Boyce Codd normal form. We'll see what is multi-valued dependency and how to remove that multi-valued dependencies from the databases. Then we understand that, what do you mean by 1NF? When we say that the tables are in 1NF, a relation or table is in 1NF if and only if all underlying domains contain atomic values. So this normal forms deals with atomic values only. That means once the table is converted to one normal form, all the domains in a table should be atomic. It must consist of only one value for column and record intersection point. This is the example we have seen. Here telephone numbers are many for the same branch. So we have to convert this table into 1NF by splitting the main table into two tables. First we'll store the branch information, whereas second we'll store the branch telephone information. Here branch number gets repeated and telephone numbers are written atomically here by writing single value in a row and column intersection point. In second normal form, a relation or table is considered into second normal form if and only if it is in 1NF. It means when you want to transform it into second normal form in any database, it has to be there into the first normal form. And every non-key attribute is fully functionally dependent on the primary key of the table. Generally, we apply second normal form to the tables which consist of composite primary keys. And what is functional dependency, students? If there are two columns into a table R, there's A and B columns into a table R, B is functionally dependent on A. If each value of A is associated with exactly one value of B in the relation R, means there is one-to-one relationship between A and B. And it will be written like this, A arrow B. It means that A determines the values of B. A determines B. And the column which appears on the left-hand side of the arrow is called as determinant column. Determinant of a functional dependency refers to an attribute or group of attributes on the left-hand side of the arrow. If the determinant can maintain the fully functional dependency with minimum number of attributes, then we can consider that table is in second NF. When you go from first NF to 2NF, we have to first identify the primary key in 1NF table. Then identify the functional dependencies. And if partial dependencies exist on the primary key of a table, then remove those partial dependencies by placing them in the new relation along with the copy of the determinant. So this example we have seen, where we have the information of staff branch and their number of hours per week the staff worked in a branch. So here, this first two columns, staff number and branch number column, both are considered composite primary key. Branch number can determine branch address. Branch address can determine branch number. Staff number can determine two columns, that is name and position. Whereas branch number and staff number combinedly determines worked hours per week that employee worked for in a branch. So this is the only column which actually fully functional dependent on the composite primary key, and rest of the columns are not. So that's why this relation or table is not in 2NF. That means that there are partial dependencies exist. So to convert it into 2NF, we will divide this table, master table, temporary staff allocation table, into three tables. One is branch master, another is staff master, and last one is the temporary staff allocation, in which we are going to record hours per week. So here we can easily add a new branch, you can easily add new staff, you can easily add how many hours that staff worked in a branch. That is possible. Coming to the third normal form, a relation is in third normal form if and only if it is in second normal form and every non-key attribute of R is non-transitively dependent on the primary key of R. So this is very important, student. Every non-key attribute of relation R is non-transitively dependent on the primary key of a table. So what do you mean by transitive dependency? Consider there are three columns in a table, that is A, B, and C. A determines B and B determines C, suppose. A determines B is represented by A arrow B, and B determines C is represented by B arrow C. Then in turns, we can say that A can determine C. Then that is called as transitive dependency. If such dependencies exist in a database, then they have to be removed from the database so that we can convert second normal form table into third normal form. So what are the steps to convert second normal form to third normal form? First step is identify the primary key of the second normal form relation or table. Then identify functional dependencies into the relation. And if you found any transitive dependency that exists on the primary key, then we remove that transitive dependency by placing that they will do a new table along with the copy of the determinant. Let's see an example. Here there is a table of staff branch. We can say that staff number can determine rest of the columns, all the columns. Branch number can determine address and telephone number. Similarly, branch number and telephone number can be determined from branch address. It means that A is to B is there, then B is to C is there, but again from C is to B is there. It means that this should not happen in 3N. So that transient dependency has to be removed. So we split this table into two tables. One is staff master and branch master. All the information of the staff will go into staff table, whereas information of branch will go into branch table. Only the one thing that we need to do here is we need to take a common column, that is branch number, as a foreign key into the staff table, so that we can link these two tables and we can perform join and to get the original table back. That is possible via joins. This is about 3NF. Now coming to the next important type of normal form, that is called as Boyce-Codd normal form. A relation or a table is in BCNF if and only if every determinant is a candidate key. In 3NF, it is not required actually. Every determinant should may or may not be a candidate key, but here in BCNF, every determinant should be a candidate key. A determinant is an attribute. What is determinant? It is an attribute possibly composite on which some other attribute is fully functionally dependent on. Right. So determinant is an attribute on which some another attribute is dependent on. Consider a table SJT, that is student, subject and teacher relation. It is a table of student, subject and teacher relation in which we have support the records like Smith, Matt, Professor White. It means Smith is a student, Matt is a subject which is taught by Professor White. Similarly, there is one more record, Smith is a student studying physics subject from Professor Green. Jones studying maths taught by Professor White. Jones studying physics taught by Professor Brown. So what type of functional dependencies exist here? We have to identify all the functional dependencies from this table. The first functional dependency that we found is the teacher can be determined from subject and the student. The subject and the student, if you combine it, take that can determine professor name. I can get the information of professor from subject and the student information. So for each subject, each student S of that subject taught by only one teacher, and this is the functional dependency, FD S, J determines professor T. Okay, teacher T. Second functional dependency that exists here is each teacher T teaches only one subject. So teacher is determining the subject. From the teacher, I can determine which subject that teacher is teaching. So T determines J here in this table. J is the subject, T is the teacher, right? So here T determines J. That is the second functional dependency that exists here. Now there is one more functional dependency, that is each subject is taught by several teachers. Now look at the subject, that is physics, which is taught by Professor Green and it is also taught by Professor Brown. So there is multi-value dependency that exists between J and T. J means subject and T means teacher. So it means that the subject is taught by many teachers. The physics subject is taught by many teachers. When this type of dependency exists, one is too many, then it is called as multi-valued dependency. In the previous two steps, that functional dependency exists is having one-to-one. Here also one-to-one. But in third step, we found that there is multi-valued dependency between the subject and the professor. It means the subject is taught by many professors here. Take an example of subjects here. You can see, there is a subject physics which is taught by two professors. One is Professor Green and another is Professor Brown. And because of this, we can consider this as a multivalent dependency. One subject, many professors. There exist, whenever you want to insert any data into this table, there exists a relation SJT with attribute S, that is student, subject, and teacher. The meaning of SJT row or tuple is that specified student is taught by specified teacher by specified subject by specified teacher. Then only we can insert such a record into the SJT relation. There are two determinants we found in above relation, that is SJ and T, which are fully functional dependent. There is no problem. But what problem will come into above table, that we'll discuss now. There is a problem of update in above table. In fact, that Jones studied physics is deleted. Suppose if the fact that Jones studied physics is deleted, then what will happen? If we delete Jones studied physics is deleted, the last row, then what will happen? The information that Professor Brown teaches physics is also gets deleted. It means there is no existence of Professor Brown in this table, right? So that should not happen. See, while deleting one subject information, the professor information is also lost. That is wrong, right? It should not happen. So the Jones studies physics is deleted. The fact that Professor Brown teaches physics is also lost. It is because the T, that is teacher column, is determinant column, but not a candidate key of the table. Now, what to do then? We can split now this table into two different tables. One is SJ and another is TJ. SJ will going to give you the information of student and the subject that they are studying, right? And the another relation will going to give you the information of all the professors and their subjects. So it means that the above table is now split into two different tables. This is our original table having three attributes. And now it is now split into two different tables. One is student master, you can say, and another is teacher master table. So SJ is student master table, whereas TJ is teacher master table. Now these two relations, that is SJ and TJ, are in BCNF because all the determinants now are candidate keys. And there we can easily delete any information, any record, without affecting another records. Like if I want to now delete Jones studying physics, I want to delete. I can easily delete without reading the information of Professor Brown's teaching subject physics. So it is because we converted that 3NF table into BCNF, and here all determinant columns are the candidate key. Which are the determinants here? Professor T teaches the subject. So from the professor, I can get the information of the subject. From the student, we can get the information of subject. So they are determinant. And now they are candidate keys. Then the next type of normal form is fourth normal form, which actually deals with the multivalued dependencies that exist into the tables. So what is multivalued dependency? First, we must know what is multivalued dependencies. Given a relation R with attributes A, B, and C, if there are three attributes, the multivalued dependencies like R dot A, double arrow, R dot B, this is the symbol, double arrow symbol we use for representing multivalued dependency. R dot B holds if and only if the set of values of B matching to only matching a given A value and C value pair in relation R only on the A value and is independent on of the C. It means that the values of B relates with more than one values of A. One to many is the relationship. When then it happens into the table, then we can say that it is multi-value dependency that we have seen in the previous example also. One subject, many teacher. There we have found the multi-value dependency. So let's see how fourth normal form can be applied to remove multi-value dependencies from the unnormalized table. Let us consider this example. What is 4NF? A relation is considered into 4NF if and only if whenever there exists a multivalent dependencies like A multivalently dependent on B, you can say, then all attributes are also functionally dependent, fully functionally dependent on A. That is, A is to X for all attributes X of the relation. Means A determines all the other attributes of the relation. Now consider a table having the information of course, teacher and text. So what is course? Is course is the subject that you are going to study. Teacher will going to give me the information of all the teachers who are teaching that particular subject, and text book, the last column, will going to give me the information of all the books that professors use to teach that particular subject. So consider that there is a subject called as, or course called as, physics taught by Professor Green, but Professor Green refers two different books, that is basic mechanics. Professor Green also refers principles of optics. So here many to many relationships that exist, or one to many relationships that exist between any two columns of this table. Similarly, there is another Professor Brown who also teaches the same subject, that is physics, and again he refers two different tables, two different textbooks, that is basic mechanics and principles of optics. There is one more professor, suppose Black, also studies, also teaching this course, that is physics, and also refers two books, that is basic mechanics and principles of optics. Now consider that there is another subject, maths, which is taught by Professor White, and he refers modern algebra as the textbooks and projective geometry as the textbooks. By looking at the data inside this relation, we can easily say that there exists a multi-value dependency. One subject, many professors, many textbooks, right? So when one is to many relationship exists in a relational database, then we can easily say that there exists a multi-value dependency in between the attributes. Let us understand by this example. A tuple in the above relation, that is city X, appears if and only if course T can be taught by teacher T and uses X as a reference book. For a given course, all possible combinations of teacher and text appear. That is, the above relation satisfies the constraint if the tuple C T1 X1 exists and C T2 exists. If both appears in the table, then the tuple C T1 X2 and C T2 X1 both also appears. So all possible combinations of subjects and the teacher should also appear into the table. To understand this, let's take an example of first row and the third row. The fourth row, first and fourth row of above table. Suppose this is C T1 X1. First row is C T1 X1. And fourth row is C T2 X2. Then you can say that we can consider both first two records also to understand this. That is C T1 X1, C T2 X2. Then all possible combinations of this should also appear. If there exists another teacher like who teaches the same subject, like fourth row now, if you consider C T2 X2, if you consider now first and fourth record exists in your table, then all possible combinations of this should also appear. So that is there in the second and third row. So whenever you insert any record of book into now this particular table, then there will be a problem. Now if I want to insert a new textbook, suppose, into this, then I must repeat that information for all the professors and all the subjects. That will be a problem because of multivalue dependency. The above table CTX contains redundancy because the information gets repeated. CTX table is in BCNF form as there are no other functional determinants, but CTX relation is not in 4NF. The above table is not in 4NF as it involves a multivalued dependency that is not at all a functional dependency in the table, let alone a functional dependency in which determinants should be a candidate key. Now let us understand what problem will going to occur in this particular table. If I try to insert one record, like to add the information that physics course uses a new textbooks now, that is called as advanced mechanics. So for this, it is necessary for me to create three new records, one for each of the three teachers. Now let us see what is there in the table. Teacher, normal teacher teaches the same subject. There are three teachers, Professor Green, Professor Brown, and Professor Black. So if I add a new textbooks here in the last column, then that information should be replicated for all the teachers. So three more records will going to come if you add a new textbooks. So that is called an insertion anomaly in the above table. To avoid that, and this should not happen, so it means that what should be there, if I want to add new textbooks into the table, it should be easily added without disturbing other records of the table. So it means that I must now divide this particular table into two tables. One is going to give me the information of course and teacher, which course is taught by which teacher, and second information would be which course having which textbook, course and their textbook. Now if you divide this table into two tables, you will get four records in each table. That is, physics is taught by three professors and math is taught by one professor, whereas physics course book has two textbooks, whereas math also has two textbooks. Now in this normalized table, can I easily add a new textbook, that is advanced mechanics, for a subject or a course physics? Yes, we can do that without affecting any other records of the table, because we removed that multi-valued dependency that exists between the previous table. So that is the job of